Here are 10 shortcuts that I use every single time I open up Premiere Pro. This video is sponsored by Adobe. Let's hop right in. To access your keyboard shortcuts, go up to Premiere Pro, Keyboard Shortcuts. The great thing about this window is if you hit any key on the keyboard, it will show you exactly what command that key does. If I press and hold down the forward delete key, you'll notice that it tells you the exact commands that that key will do, as well as if you were to add any modifiers. Like if I add shift, the command would be ripple delete, which leads me to the first shortcut that I use all the time, ripple deleting. Now, staying inside my keyboard shortcuts menu, I want to showcase to you that you can actually apply two different keyboard shortcuts to the same command. Because I ripple delete a lot while editing, I also want to apply the T key as a shortcut. So to do this, I'll go to the search bar, type in ripple delete, double click in the negative space right here, and I'll hit the T key. Below, it will give you a warning if you are going to override any previous shortcuts with that keystroke. Because I don't use the type tool very much, I'm completely fine with having T as a shortcut for ripple delete. I'll hit OK, and let's say we want to completely get rid of this turtle clip. Highlight the clip, I'll hit T to ripple delete that clip. And what ripple deleting does is delete the section that's highlighted and shift all of the clips over. Now let me undo that, and let's say I wanted to get rid of a whole section of clips here. From the time this person jumps over the fence all the way to when this dog is grabbing this stick. A common way to ripple delete in this case would be to set an in and out point. So I'll hit I on my keyboard where I want my in point to be. Then I'll scrub over to where the dog is biting the stick, and I'll hit O on my keyboard to set my out point. And if I hit the keyboard shortcut to ripple delete, it will delete everything that's within the in and out brackets. I hit T, and we ripple deleted that whole section. Now let me go over a similar method called ripple trimming. And let's say I actually wanted to keep this turtle clip, but only the part where the turtle falls off the log like this. On the keyboard, I'll hit the Q key, and notice how it ripple trimmed from the playhead to the previous edit point. And now I want to ripple trim from my playhead to the next edit point. From this point forward, if I hit W, it deleted everything in that space and shifted everything over. To recap, when ripple trimming, it's Q and W. Instead of creating cuts or splits on the clip by using the razor tool, the command that I think is faster is to add edit. If you're unfamiliar with add edit, if you move the playhead anywhere along the timeline and hit command K on Mac or control K on Windows, it creates cuts on the clips. Instead of having command K as my add edit shortcut, I've switched that to F. Now let's talk about select clip at playhead. By default, you can do this by hitting the D key. So with the playhead above my clip, if I hit D, it will select clip at playhead. Two other things to add to selecting a clip. One is the modifier of holding option while you're selecting the clip. So if I hold option on Mac or alt on Windows and select the clip, that will allow me to select only the video or only the audio. To add on to this is nudging clips up and down. With the clip highlighted, hold option and hit the up or down arrows to nudge the clip up or down. A super simple concept, but I use that all the time. Let's talk about duplication. If I click this clip over here and I hold option while I click and drag it, now I have created a duplicate of that clip. I use this method all the time when I'm duplicating something in the sequence. And speaking of duplicating in sequences, the next one I want to talk about is duplicating sequences. Normally you could do this by right-clicking on the sequence and hit duplicate. I do this quite often, so I like to have a shortcut key for it. So what I've done is taken the same keyboard stroke for when you're in Photoshop and you need to duplicate a layer by hitting Command J on Mac or Control J on Windows and applying that here. If I hit Command J, it automatically creates a copy of the sequence and I can continue working on the sequence. Or if for some reason I have to go back to a previous iteration of my sequences, they're right there. Before I show you more of the shortcuts I use, if you're finding these tips helpful so far and you want to grow your Premiere Pro knowledge, then I would highly suggest checking out the on-demand sessions from this year's Adobe Max. At the time of this upload, Adobe's creative conference, Adobe Max, just took place. It's a free and virtual event. Adobe Max features live and on-demand content, including more than 400 sessions, labs, keynotes, musical performances, special guest appearances, and a sneak peek at all the things being worked on at Adobe. You want to brush up on your Premiere Pro skills? Here's 60 sessions. After Effects? Here's 45 sessions. Want to learn about all the new features in Photoshop? Like, no joke, during their keynote, they showcased this new neural filter where you can automatically change a black and white photo to color with just the click of a button. I first saw that and my mind was blown. I still see it and my mind is blown. Crazy. You can see it for yourself and learn so much more about all the Adobe products by clicking on the link in my description. Again, it is completely free, so if you want to check it out, go ahead. Another one I use all the time is to enable a clip, and more so to unenable a clip, but the keyboard stroke is to enable the clip. Let's say in this example, I wanted to A/B test how these two different clips look at this part in the timeline. And what you normally would do is right click and click enable, and that would unenable the clip on the top, thus making it easy for you to see the clip on the bottom. But the keyboard shortcut for this is Shift Command E on Mac or Shift Control E on Windows. So you can quickly unenable and enable your clips with that shortcut key. Chances are while you're editing, you're also zooming in and out on the timeline. By default, that's the plus and equals key to zoom in, the minus key to zoom out, and one that people may not know about is the backslash key will zoom to sequence. So I zoom in by hitting the plus or equals sign, hit the minus to zoom out, and I'll zoom in again. And if I hit the backslash key, it will automatically fit your whole sequence to the timeline. Just to give you a better example, let me move this clip all the way over here. Let me zoom in again. I'll hit the backslash. It zooms out to the whole sequence. And the cool thing is, if I hit the backslash one more time, it will go back to my previous zoomed in spot, like that. And also sticking with the topic of zooming in, if you want to have a window take up the entire screen, all you have to do is put that cursor above whatever window that is and hit the tilde key. That's the key right underneath your escape key. So I'll hit tilde and that makes this full screen. Hit tilde again, it takes it off. Now, if you're looking to make your program monitor full screen, just hit control tilde and now your program monitor will play full screen. To go back to normal, just hit control tilde again. One thing I find myself doing often is switching between my windows, and specifically the project window, the effects window, and the effects control window. To bring those up quickly, if you hit Shift 1, you'll bring up your project window. If you hit Shift 5, you'll bring up your effects control window, and if you hit Shift 7, that brings up the effects window. So if you're ever editing and you want to access those windows quickly, remember those three: Shift 1, Shift 5, and Shift 7. One major aspect of Premiere Pro that has a big effect on some of the shortcuts that I talked about in this video, like ripple deleting and selecting your clip at the playhead, is your track targeting. So if you want to learn all about that little section over to the left of the timeline inside Premiere Pro, I made a video about it right here. And until next time, my name's Javier Mercedes, and I hope you're out there living a life of abundance. Bye.